No doubt about the winner in the game. And he can dance as well.
There you go, eh? The moves are me, mate.
Welcome back to Run Junkie, and now we can officially say track has begun because Usain Bolt has made his track debut running 10:05 in the 100 with an easy win out in the Cayman Islands.
Officially, but over at the Shanghai Diamond League, men's 800 race.
Weird.
Super weird. Should have been a 144 race, but pacemaker, field event people on the track. He didn't start with the gun. David Rudisha fades to sixth place.
What?
But women's 1500, Faith Kipyegon of Kenya, new national record, 356.82.
We also were live though at the Adidas Germany meet where we saw not one, not two, but three world leads in the women's 5K and the men's and women's 10K. That's right, all Ethiopians, 14.46, 30.56, and 27.19. We also had the conference action starting with the SEC's 200 meter sprint madness. That's right, Nathaniel Mitchell Blake of LSU wins 19.95 sub 20 seconds for the junior out of LSU. And that wasn't just the only fast performance in the 200 because Felicia Brown, she might make the Olympic team. I'm telling you, she ran into a headwind 22.26. Into a headwind.
I really want to say it.
Bye, Felicia.
Texas A&M, Lyndon Victor PR'd in 9 out of 10 events in the men's decathlon. 8,446 points. He is now the fourth best decathlete of all time behind three Olympians.
And also impressive, we now can officially say he's back because Donovan Brazier, while he didn't get the win in the 800, he ran a 146 low outdoor PB for him. Impressive. Lawson McBride and his teammate. I think his injury from indoors is officially gone. He is now a contender.
And back in the game.
Speaking of back, Ed Chez got his first victory of the outdoor season. Sounds
finally
weird when I say it out loud. He's the only guy to break 29 minutes in the Pac-12. 10K gets the win, and you would think, you know, Oregon men, Oregon women cleaned up Pac-12 titles, but guess who scored more points in the men's distance?
The home team?
The Washington Huskies.
That's
60 points to
what?
Oregon's 42.
And Colorado scored 40, but Washington, man, Isaac Yorks,
Colby Gilbert,
Aaron Nelson, and the Steeples showing up big time. Mm-hmm. And also, big time action, the Big Tens. And your alma mater, they got the win, but they had to share it with Minnesota.
They had to share it with Minnesota. In a year where Aaron Finn is redshirting, the Michigan women pulled it off, came down to the 4x4. They are co-champions.
Both score 106 points. So how do we settle this tie? What's the plan? How about this?
A two-man sack race will be held on consecutive Sundays until a champion is crowned.
Over at the Big 12 Championships, Texas men and women cleaned up the team titles per usual. Courtney Okolo practically jogs a 400-meter victory, doesn't even need water.
Also, surprisingly, Oklahoma State's Joshua Thompson was a top qualifier in the 8 and the 15, but did not run in either finals because they were on a Sunday, and Josh Thompson is Mormon, so he didn't run. And I got us thinking, Jared Ward, Mormon in the marathon, the Olympic marathon is on a Sunday. What are you gonna do?
I have no idea!
Over ACC's, the Virginia Tech men cleaned up on the backs of their pole vaulting crew. That's right, they went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in the pole vault, scoring 38 of 39 total points, which actually was a point total they needed to win the meet.
Woo! On the women's side, Molly Seidel, four-time NCAA champ, did not compete at ACC's and then later announced she does have a sacral stress fracture. We will have a new NCAA 10K champion.
And that live event going on this weekend, we had the Portland Twilight where we saw Kate Grace throw down a 2 flat in the 800, showing she's back. Alexa Ephraimson wants 2 flat 99, showing she's fit. Ooh, women's 800 just keeps on getting better.
A little better all the time.
And the Swarthmore final qualifier is actually going down tonight. We're filming this Monday afternoon. You're watching this Tuesday morning, so you know the result already. We don't, but this is what happened.
Watch this, Kate Murphy on the outside. Here goes Murphy. Oh, can Murphy get her at the line? And Mariel Hiles is just gonna hold on. Oh, and it looks like Murphy just got her at the line. Madness with a late kick, but David Torrance coming through as well. It looks like, David Torrance to the line.
You got your fix.